ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to Let's Play Fallout New Vegas. We're in the truck at about 6 o'clock in the morning. Moving people out of my path towards the driver's seat because we're going to Novak. Pretty much. That's exactly where we're going. I need to refresh my memory a little with regards to our objectives and things, but we're pretty much, as far as I can remember, traveling up through the Mojave Desert towards the H&H Tools Factory. I mean, that's the ultimate goal. So, I mean, maybe stopping off to do a few things along the way. And actually, once we're done with the H&H Tools Factory, I'm going to wander off all the way to the top of the damn map so we can kill that other fellow for Randall. So, yeah. Out of my... This is why I have to move you guys around all the time. You just... Oh, yeah, we need to pick up Russell from the, what's it called? The 188, I think. While we're at it as well, so... Anyway. Just refreshing my memory, there's obviously been a break in the recording since the last episode. I'm a little bit fuzzy on all the details. Oh yeah, we need to find people for the Tops Casino. Like, entertainers and whatnot. Of which there is one here in Novak, I think. Ooh, tumbleweed. Saw. Here we are. Now, I believe you wanted to do something here. I don't remember exactly what it was.
You call that a lizard? I fought bigger lizards with a switchblade. What's with the look, Six? It happened, okay? I still got the scars.
Mm-hmm.
Really, anyway. You get the room, and I'll get the booze.
What? You didn't say you were coming here to just sit in a room and get drunk. Fuck that, mate. I think I've already got a room anyway. It's up there somewhere. Alright, I'm a little lost here. What's going on? Get a room at the Dino Delight Motel. We've got one. It's up there. I'm a little... We can't get a room from Jeannie Mae because she's dead. Not that I ever know anything about that. Nothing to do with it whatsoever. But she's dead, dude. I don't know how we... What? Quest marker. Oh, quest marker. Please help me. What do I do? There isn't one. Grand. Okay. So, well, I'm going to go talk to the bloke upstairs here, because if he's still here, that is. Hello, Daisy Whitman. Is it this one? Hello? Apparently it wasn't this one. God. Maybe it was this one. Ah! Hello! Good sir. Why are you sleeping? It's like, well, I suppose
it is. Are running for their lives. That'll show everyone what we... Oh, it's you again. What is it?
Aren't you that singer from, I think I heard... Whatever. This one.
Oh, so you have heard of me. Yeah, that's right. I was the big draw at the Shark Club. People used to pay hundreds of caps to see me.
If you're looking for work as a singer, Tommy Torini at the Tops is hiring.
Really? The Tops, huh? Well, it's no Shark Club, but I hear security on the Strip is real tight. Even Mr. Bishop wouldn't hit a joint like that. I'll check it out. Thanks.
Nice.
Yeah.
Four remaining, apparently. Bloody hell. It's a start. It's a start. Paying off our debt of sorts to the Tops. But yeah, dude, I think this is our one. I got this ages ago. I believe I've still got it. It's
That's
still
what
mine.
I'm talking about. This ain't too shabby, this place.
Yeah, sure. Aside from all the burn marks on the carpet and the flaking wallpaper and ceiling. So what now? You're just gonna sit here, I suppose. Dog meat. Ugh. Go on a bit. Dirty water. Lovely, lovely, lovely. I don't think I stored anything here, did I? Nope. Pretty sure. Oh my god. No, that's not what I meant to do. That's what I meant to do. You think people will be more picky about saving electricity in the post-apocalyptic world, but whatever. So what now?
Denver triple dog. Jets take you up, steady to bring you back down, then psycho for the hell of it. You game?
Fucking no.
I guess this is going to be a one-man party then. Yeah. That's the stuff.
You really are just deplorable. So this deal thing.
Fuck that, man. I ain't doing shit today.
You what? I'll
deal with it tomorrow. I'm heading to a new dimension.
Bert, hammer, Niner, face, now, please. Great, no one's listening to me today. Remind me why we picked this guy up again? Ugh. Wait for Niner to sober up. Fine! I shall wait elsewhere, however. Come on, you two. Is he going to still stick around in my... Oh no, he's not even on the companions bar anymore. Fair enough. Whatever! See you around, Niner. What are you doing, dude? Oh god. Right then. Was there anything else for us to do here in Novag? I don't think so. Better go drive up the road then. ...188 trading post. Check out one drug-addicted loser and we'll gain one... ...Bowie knife-obsessed... ...nutter. With a burnt toast face. You win some, you lose some. Oh, we need to backtrack a little as well down the road, because that's where Guitar Man is. So, I almost forgot. For those of you, by the way, as just a random talking point, who've been sort of saying, oh, what happens when Fallout 4 comes out? You're just going to abandon New Vegas? No, of course I'm not. There you are!
Hello.
Come on, fucking... Fire Gecko Dundee.
Yeah. Locked and loaded.
That's what I like to hear. Let's not delve into that right now. We've just said hello.
Hi.
So I'll get into another bloody political debate with Russell. It never ends well.
Damn, dust gets in everything here. Gonna have to clean my rifle again.
Has Nina been putting stuff in your drinks too, Bert? Because you're acting pretty weird today. More than usual, I mean. Alright then, so we've got a Russell, we've
that
got a Bert.
Leader shouldn't have messed with our great army.
And we've got a Rex that's sort of, I think he's having a bad brain day. He's whatever. We'll leave him to it. Hoover Dam, NCR and proud. Really. So yeah, no, people have been asking, like, are you going to just abandon New Vegas before Fallout 4 comes out? No, I'm not. I don't know, just something about that image right there just looks gorgeous. If I wasn't so lazy, I'd take this and use it as a thumbnail for the video. Or something. Anyway, that's the wrong way. We actually need to go this way, I think. Because that way doth leadeth to build a city. I'm not gonna abandon this when Fallout 4 comes out. I've already said this umpteen times, but you know, I'll say again. You will not see a Fallout 4 series from me until at least a year or maybe even 2 years after the game is out. The simple reason for that is, one, I'm already playing this. Two, oh God, you really are having a strange day, but I want to wait for all the patches and DLC to be released. And three, I want to wait for all the needs and mods to be released. I don't think I've ever LP'd a Bethesda game right after it had come out. I've always waited until, you know, mods and patches and things are out for it. That's what I did with Skyrim. That's what I'll do with Fallout 4 as well. I mean, you'll probably see me stream it on Twitch for sure. So if you follow my Twitch channel, I will be streaming it probably. Maybe. I don't know. I haven't decided, really. I might just get stuck into it and keep it all to myself and be selfish like that. But I might stream it, and you'll have to forgive me if, obviously, I do get, you know, a bit distracted by Fallout 4 during at least the release week. You know, it's only fair. I'm sure a bunch of you are going to be fairly distracted as well by Fallout 4. But, yeah, no. New Vegas ain't going nowhere. And to be quite honest with you, I think the chances are, after Fallout 4's come out and the initial sort of novelty value of it being a brand new Bethesda game has worn off, I will probably come to the conclusion that I still like New Vegas more. I like New Vegas more than Fallout 3. And Fallout 4 really just sort of, to me, as cool as it will probably be, it does very much look like Fallout 3.5. At least in the sense that it's very Bethesda-y and not very Obsidian-y. It's not on the West Coast, for after all, and if a Fallout game is not set on the West Coast, then I care a whole lot less about it, to be honest with you. I just do. The Western US is the home of Fallout, and it will always be the home of Fallout. It's where Fallout 1 was set, it's where Fallout 2 was set, it's where New Vegas is set. It's just the way it is. Fallout Bethesda's little spin-off thing they're doing on the East Coast is fun, but it's not the series I grew up playing, I'll put it that way. Son of a bitch. That is one big fucking ant, guys.
Guess they're all dead or run off.
I'm glad you're so chill about it. Son of a bitch, that thing is huge. It ate up like 6 shots from this thing. Mother of God. This was a work of fire ant. I mean, just Jesus Christ. I shudder to think what the soldier ants are like. I didn't realize fire ant nectar was worth so much. Huh. Another little one over there. Can't be asked to deal with him. Oh my God, those ones look huge as well. Yeah. You could have picked a better spot to camp out at, dude. What the fuck is he? Hey, guitar dude. What in the world? He was here a second ago. Oh, there he is. Did you just scarp her as soon as the shooting started? Oh, you saw that ant coming a mile off and just ran for it like a sensible person, I suppose. Fair enough.
I believe that the fiends are gone when they stop their raiding and pillaging. Howdy there, partner.
Tommy Torini at the top is looking for musical acts if you're interested.
Maybe it's time to give these tired old bones a rest. All right, show me what you've got.
I'm giving you a real opportunity here. How about some compensation? Come on.
I suppose it's only right you get a little something for your troubles. Here, my daddy left me this gun. Guess I don't need it no more.
Sweet. What did he give me? A 357 Magnum revolver. Or possibly a 10mm pistol. I'm not sure which. No, 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 no. Here we go. Here we go. Mysterious Magnum. Right. Damage 40. Ooh, it's better than this. That's so cool. Yes. Yes.
You got a death wish?
No. Let's say that again. Say that again while I could, while I. Man, that is going to get old really fast, but I don't even care. Oh my god. You know what? In all the years I've played this game, I never did get my hands on that. I don't think I bothered to increase barter high enough. Right, that's going on. I could even put scope on it as well. That probably makes it go all weird, though. Jesus, that thing's got a massive head. There we go. Don't look so pissed off, Russell. Well, you know. It's like, you know, telling the sky not to be quite so blue. I like it. 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 It even looks good. Anyway, moving on. What were we even doing? I've completely lost track now. I got distracted by the nice, shiny musical gun. We are. We're going north somewhere, aren't we? We're going to the H&H Tools Factory. That's it. That's the one. That's the ticket. Since Nina's just off on a sort of drug binge, we could stand to go and pick up someone at the Lucky 38. Maybe Veronica. Or Cass. We still haven't investigated that caravan with Cass, which sort of annoys me a bit, but on the other hand, we've not actually been anywhere with Veronica for freaking ages, and I kind of miss her, to be honest with you. Power armor nutter with a power fist. Except I didn't give her a power fist, I gave her something else, didn't I? Sort of zap glovey thing, but I might have taken it off her because it did this annoying thing where it made the whole screen flash whenever she hit something with it. Which would be kind of funny if it played a sort of Adam West Batman sort of POW thing every time it did it, but no. I seem to have the monopoly on weird weapons that make noises. Get away from my truck!
The Legion can count on that.
Yeah, you tell them, Rex. You just... for Jesus, it's a bit close for comfort there. We need to scare him a bit, not go straight for the balls. Jesus. Right, so. We have acquired one mysterious Magnum. For our troubles, which is pretty cool. I need to whip it out every time I make a really bad pun. Shouldn't I really? Yeah. Anyway, so moving on. World map. No, I do not want to set my marker. Sorry. Vault 34. No. There must be a reason that's on our map, but I don't know. Bill's Shack. Is that it? No. No, we're going to the old Tumbleweed Ranch to find this Tommy guy. I think it's up there somewhere. Before that, we are going to the H&H Tools Factory, which is somewhere around here. Quests. We can rebuild him. There we go. Ah, there it is. There it is. H&H Tools. Right there next to North Vegas Square. So, pile on into the truck, everybody. Now, am I going to drive to Vegas to pick up... I can't be arsed. I really can't be bothered. No, next time we're actually in Vegas, we'll pick up a few people from the Lucky 38, but for now, I can't be bothered. It's just wasting time, more detours. So, where's the closest we can get to where we want to be? Freeside, maybe. The west side pawn shop's too far in the other direction, so... yeah, Freeside, I guess. Oh, and ironically, that's going to take us right into the strip, isn't it? I forgot. Oh, crap. Bollocks. Oh, God. Bird is in shog-off mode again. I suppose we might as well go and get Veronica, then. Fuck it. When does Fallout 4 even come out anyway? Back on that subject again. I think it's like November the 10th or something. I don't know. I've got it pre-ordered. Physical boxed collector's edition copy, because I'm a complete sap and I actually fall for that sort of thing. Although in my defense, actually, I didn't bother to do that with Skyrim. I just got the regular version. And I don't know. Bethesda's games are usually worth... one of the few games worth getting all the random sort of bits of knickknacks and stuff with them. So, yeah, I'm gonna go up to the penthouse, and I'm just gonna save this here because, in my previous experience, oh come on.
Where to, partner?
Bloody presidential suite, please. Yeah, my previous experience, this place starts to sort of goes a bit bananas when it comes to my crash detection and stuff. So, hi Cass. We'll do this caravan thing at some point, I swear.
What's up?
Hi.
Let's go make trouble.
Yes, let's. Having some lip-syncing issues there, are you?
High roller suite.
Yes, very, very good. Casino.
Casino floor.
I don't like the Lucky 38. It makes creepy noises. Right then, so. Welcome back to the group, or whatever. Yeah, you have got the zap glove, haven't you? Well, you can keep it for now. Just, we'll see how annoying it gets. But it's not half as annoying as this. Yeah. I love how when you get into Freeside, everything just turns grey and horrible all of a sudden.
Move along.
Like, even the sky is slightly less saturated. Right, then. So, Veronica, welcome back to the group. We weren't actually going to pick you up originally, it's just... I accidentally, I suppose, drove the truck, or rather it drove itself, into the middle of Freeside. right up to the strip gate, and I didn't intend for it to do that, but here we are nevertheless. We met this bloke called Niner. I don't think you've met him yet. In fact, no, you haven't. He's a weird one. Would you keep it down out there? Please. For the love of... what is going on? I know he's called Freeside Thug, but I don't see what he's doing to demand being, you know, executed by firing squad. Whatever.
Come to Mick and Ralph's for all your shopping needs.
Speaking of people that ought to be executed by firing squad. Roman Fort. Yes, we've got a few things, bits and bobs to do for the followers, haven't we? But not right now. I need to go kill people and find grills. Not necessarily in that order, come to think of it. Once again, sentences only heard in the Mojave Wasteland. I need to go kill people and find grills. I'm here to kill people. I'm here to find grills. And I can't find any grills. So, I think we need to go off or around that way. Sort of general direction. Better whip out the old Enfield. Because... musical pistol is not gonna really help me much out here, to be fair. Okay, so North Sewers, no thanks. As a matter of fact, no thank you, no sir. Okay, up here and then take a left. We're in fiend territory, folks. I think I've killed everyone up here, but you know, better be safe rather than sorry. This. What? Speaking of. Oh my god. Jesus Christ. What is going on? Well, those two are extremely dead. I have no idea what killed them. I just heard an automatic weapon followed by death. Right, everybody. Watch the fuck out. This. Fuck it. This. Jackal gang members. Well, whoever it was has beef with the Jackal gang, and I can't really say I blame them too much. Still. Seriously, what the hell killed these guys? Did they just kill each other? Didn't look like it. I heard machine gun fire or something like that, and then... splat. But it can't have been each other, because they're armed with... well, a lead pipe and a crowbar, so... the fuck is going on? Alright, whatever. Moving on. Oh. Bars are appearing at the bottom of the screen. That usually means... yeah. Something's about to go down. Russell, knife. Dude, no. No, 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 no. No. Bad Russell.
I can do... good call.
Damn right it's a good call. Well, he didn't last long, did he? That has gone absolutely no way in explaining what happened here whatsoever. Anyway, never mind. We found the H&H Tools Factory. I guess that's all that matters. So, H&H Tools Factory. What do you reckon's waiting in here for us then? Because the chances of it just being empty and deserted and then us finding a bunch of grills lying around is pretty much, yeah. Freaking thought so. Oh, brilliant! You've got the zap glove, of course! Oh my god. Right, come on. Guys, if you could stop killing everything before I get a chance to blow it away with this, I'd appreciate it. No, I'm just gonna switch to something else. This with the... Have I got any pulse slugs? There we go, right. And there we go, flashlight, awesome. Okay, so, robots. That was my first guess. You guys are too bloody efficient. That's you not. That's your problem, really. This is what I get for dragging along three melee characters and one guy who really, really, really likes to go melee even when I tell him not to. They sort of have a way of rushing in, sort of destroying everything before I can get a shot off. But whatever. Robo brain brain chunks. No thanks. I know a particular dark elf who likes to collect bits of brain and sell them, but well, no, it wasn't him, was it? It was Zog that collected bits of brain and sold them, wasn't it? Yeah. Get my bloody characters mixed up now, Jesus. Losing the plot, folks. Oh god! One of those days. Hail Hydra. That's all I have to say to that. Oh, and we got a New Vegas anti-crash message as well. Ah, wonderful. Oh, yeah, and I forgot. Crazy visuals because of that mod I installed. I'm guessing the footsteps, like an era Bert rubbing up against something. Wow, yeah, my anti-crash is going crazy. I don't know why. Whatever, I'll ignore it for now. Replica repeater. Hello. Damage 37. It's not that brilliant, is it really, but still. It does look the business. For sure. Yeah, look at that. Jesus, it's kind of cool. Anyone want a replica repeater?
I don't understand the fuss over Sunset Sarsaparilla. Tastes like rancid fruit to me.
Not bad. Hydra's worn off. Fine. So what did we? Ooh. How did I not set that off? Lucky 38 VIP key card. Hello. What? What did I pick up there? Picked up a shotgun that I really don't need. Where is it? Oh, weird. I don't... Okay, anyway. Anthony House's terminal. Science skill of 50 is... Veronica! I'm suddenly incredibly glad we brought you along. Hello, dearie. Could you possibly do something about this computer? If I can remember how to get you to do something about computers... I can get you to heal me? Oh, cool. All right, here we go. I've missed having tech support with me. I love this. even if she does intend on typing in midair. But that's just how she does it. I mean, I'm not going to, like I said before, oh, hello. I'm not going to question it, just because, sweet, well done. Mwah, you're awesome. Right, so, I bet this has got nothing of value in it now. Building the things you need to build a better tomorrow. Employee access terminal. This looks interesting. Lucky 38 executive override. Start what did I just do? Whatever. Journal entry. 05-14-2061. As the years roll on, I find myself missing father's advice more and more. I wonder if he would be proud of the decisions I've made, but no. Such second-guessing does me no good. I won't be weighed down by the past, and I won't waste energy on ancient family history, especially when that history isn't really family at all. I'm beginning to mistrust Henderson. I think he's conspiring with my bastard half-brother to seize the company. I built this company, damn it. I won't be ousted by some Johnny-come-lately fancy college man with his robots and his degrees. I've asked Cindy Lou to keep an eye on him, to monitor his email for suspicious activity. They've all turned against us, haven't they? Cindy Lou is right. I've had no choice. May God forgive me for what I've done. All my employees, all those people I thought loyal friends. Was I wrong? Am I crazy? I've scattered this journal across all the terminals in the office just in case. They won't take me without a fight. As soon as I finish this entry, I'm activating the security systems. If you're reading this and you're American, God bless the USA. If you're reading this and you're my brother, see you in hell, Alexander House. Interesting. The plot thickens. Yeah. Suspicious terminal. That usually means it's going to explode if I do anything with it. But it's still stuck downstairs. Okay, no. HR email from Cindy Lou Kreb, human resources to all personnel, subject new employee policies. Effective immediately, the following company policies are in place. 1. All cameras are forbidden in office areas and on the factory floor. No more than 3 employees are permitted in the break rooms at any time. In accordance with the wishes of the management, all bathrooms have been sealed off and walled over. Employees are requested to attend to all waste disposal needs before or after work hours. If you have any questions about these policies, please email Human Resources. Thank you. Cindy Lou Kreb, H&H Tools, Human Resources. From Cindy Lou Kreb. Blah, 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 blah. Hello again, everybody. Mr. H has requested that the following rules be added to the H&H Tools employee policies. Please note that these rules are effective immediately. Employees will conduct all spoken language business in English. Yes, this includes dealing with international clients. 2. Rooftop access is strictly prohibited. 3. All employees must submit to random DNA screenings to isolate the traitor gene. Cindy Lou Kreb. Hello, fellow H&H employees. Mr. H has asked me to pass on the details of our new security systems. This is very important, so please read it and confirm via email that you understand the procedures. 1. Automated heavy turrets have been installed in both cubicle areas, the central catwalk, and outside Mr. H's office. You must have your ID pass on you at all times, or the turrets will open fire, and we certainly don't want that, do we, smiley face? Remember, no sudden movements until you hear the click. That means the turret has recognized your ID signature, and you're safe to pass. Employees must submit at least one of the following on the first payday of each month. 1 vial of blood, 20 nail clippings, toenail or fingernail is fine, but not a mix of both. 1 lock of hair or a 5 square centimeter skin sample. These samples will be retained for monitoring purposes. Any employees seen to be cohabitating, colluding or cogitating with any of the following groups will be terminated immediately. Foreigners, masons, carpenters, tragic players. Tragic the Garnering. I remember that from the old Fallout games. Jesus. Illegal aliens, extraterrestrials, or the Flemish. 4. If you see Mr. H in the halls, do not make eye contact. Making eye contact with Mr. H will be seen as an attempt to steal his thought energy and will be grounds for immediate dismissal. Yes, even if Mr. H is wearing his special hat. Thank you all for your patience with our little reorganization. Now get out there and make the best gosh darn tools in the West. Cindy Lou Kreb, H&H Tools, Human Resources Department. Access hidden network drive. Journal entry. Cindy Lou can no longer save me. Oops, I did not mean to do that. free money. Not gonna turn that down anymore. No. Right. Thank you very much. Oh! Very, very cunning. Whatever that was that exploded. Very cunning indeed. Now, where the hell did Chasm leave me? It left me here, thank God. Right, is this thing gonna... Yep, it is. God, it feels like forever since we've actually shot anything, come to think of it. Aha. Tripwires. Keep an eye out for... Oh God, nobody move! Nobody move! Sweet Jesus. God, you were that close to just running around into this... Oh, like an... Oh God, we would be so dead. We would be so very dead. I will leave the big grenade bouquet alone. Auto dock Mark 3 OS holodisc. Alright. Oh, magnum rounds. Lovely. Thank you very much. More free money. Lest thee forget, I can actually turn scrap metal into Legion coins. It's part of a ongoing scheme to devalue the Legion Aureus completely. To the point where the Legion is crippled and eventually brought down, not through strength of arms, but by inflation. Yes, it's a cunning plan. Yes, I'm a genius, I know. Oh God, here we go again. No, here we go. It's worse than I feared. Henderson sent a 10-point memo outlining the benefits of mechanization and automation. As if I wouldn't know he's been plotting with my half-brother the entire time. I knew he was a weasel dick traitor from the moment I laid eyes on him. Only one thing to do. One thing. And the company, my father's legacy, is safe forever. Police car. Cindy Lou will bring him to me and then I'll make an example. The bastard will learn why you don't cross the house. Okay. Went in there already. It's about to shoot you then. Oh God! I'm really not having much luck today, am I? Chasm, please tell me that you didn't just like... Oh for fuck's sake, seriously Chasm. What do I got here? Yeah, this will probably do the trick. Oh my word! Is that grenade bouquet in the next room so goddamn powerful that it can knock me out even on the other side of a wall? Jesus Christ. Right, everyone just...
Beats wait until they shoot me first.
That's not what I meant.
Should have brought something to read.
Yeah. Hold your fucking horses while I... Deal with that. You can all move again, folks. Right. I'm trying to think if there's anything we... oh, there was that. For all the good it's worth. And there was those. Oh, and there was the scrap metal in the fire hose box. Gotcha. Quick save! Oh! Truck fuel. Out of the way, dude. Come on. And there was this. There we go. It adds notes, which I don't know, may be important somehow, which is why I'm doing it again. Okay, went in. Fucking hell, how did I not see those? Where the hell did you come from? Why did you all... What? Right, over here, now. I don't know where Bert is. Let's hope he doesn't turn up and... Alright, he's off that way somewhere. Oh my word. I feel like it might be just safer running off down the hallway and then trying to blow it up from a distance, but... Yep. Okay. Whew. Need I remind you that my explosive skill is so terrible that... Okay. I just ran across a tripwire. I level up, eh? Nice. I really don't know what to increase, honestly. Lockpicking, maybe? Medicine? Energy weapons, guns. You can't go wrong with either of those, can you, really? Survival? Survival. My tea-making skills could do with an increase, perhaps. Because I've got nothing better to spend it on, why not? There we go. I just wasted a bunch of skill points. Cue everybody in the comments having a go at me. Right. Let's try and keep this brief. I have a bad habit of just spending like half an hour just on the perks page, so... Your attacks do much less damage to companions, allowing you to liberally spray an area with reckless abandon. I don't think that was really ever a factor in stopping me from recklessly spraying the area with abandon with weapons, I should point out, before anyone makes any funny comments. Man in their shoes, Night Stalker... Oh, that's the weird Night Stalkers thing, yeah. You've achieved too much, and now is the perfect time to celebrate. Upon taking this, yeah, this is the one. You'll receive multiple boxes filled with alcoholic drinks. Fists of Steel. And Veronica is one of your companions. You and your companions have a 10% chance to knock down your enemy with an unarmed weapon. It's kind of cool, actually. I don't know. Have I got a power fist on me? I can't remember. Kind of makes me want to equip one. Explorer. Every location in the world is revealed on your map. No, that's not that. Ugh, I can see that almost crashing the game or something. Atomic. I never use VATs anyway, so maybe I should actually, though. Strength requirements are 2 points lower than normal. Tag. Oh, fourth tag skill. Maybe it could be kind of... No. People probably yell at me for doing that as well, just like I did with the here and now thing. Heavily trained. Action boy. Purifier. Prowler. Maybe. Gnomes only receive 50% of the damage they normally would. Ugh, that's tempting. I could almost do that. Autodidact. Trained yourself to use power armors and power helmets. I'm kind of less bothered about that than I once was. I'm going to leave that for now, honestly. I don't think I have a second suit of power armor in any decent condition anyway. And I think I can pick that up for free somewhere as well. In a number of places, that particular perk. So again, I think it's a waste of a perk. Or so I'm told. That's kind of cool, though. Your companions are a bunch of wimps, and you need to motivate your squad to fight harder. If you successfully take down an enemy in the first 10 seconds of combat, your companions will hit critically for the next 5 seconds. Oh my god. Yes. That is, like, that you have no idea how much that's going to help with a lot of the New Vegas bounty stuff. Trust me. Right, so... Email from Dobson O'Gill. To Jack Maynard. What the jumping monkey fuck? Are you out of your mind? You think they aren't monitoring emails? Don't send me that seditious... Don't send that seditious shit my way. Alright. Should have guessed, like, this guy... The guy who runs this, or ran this place, was paranoid as all hell. I don't know why I didn't expect landmines everywhere, and tripwires, and grenade bouquets and shit. Oh, hello. Have I hotkeyed any stim packs? I'm trying to think, because I'm getting kind of annoyed about having to go back into my menu all the time. No. 8 will now be the stim pack button. Henceforth, let it be known throughout all of the kingdom. 8 is now the stim pack button. I really don't know. I've really lost it. I think it's all the explosions that's sending me a bit dilally. Alan Dalton to Jenny DeSoto. Jenny, what the hell is up with these guys? They've been coming after our market share like they've got something to prove. No, strike that. This feels personal. Did Mr. H run over Robco's dog or something? P.S. My wife's got out of town for the weekend. Why don't you come over after work Friday? Bring the accordion and the riding crop. Jesus. From Jack Maynard. What the jumping monkey fuck, Dob? Have you seen these new HR rules? What the hell is going on here? I swear, if this place didn't have great benefits, I'd be out of here. From Jenny DeSoto. Hey, sexy, I just fed Alan a line about having to play the Loch Ness Monster in a play this weekend, so I'm so I'm free Friday night. Want me to bring the stovepipe and the souvenir moon rocks? Dobbs, Jenny said your brother might know something about these Robco guys that are kicking our asses on the trading floor. You heard anything, Alan? P.S. The wife's away this weekend and Jenny's busy. Why don't you bring over the rubber sheets and the souvenir elephant foot trash can? Remind me what I've been missing. I'm done. 10 out of 10. New Vegas developers. I'm done.